singles competition here on Shotgun. And what a reaction. We don't know too much about this individual, but we understand he's going to be a tremendous athlete and upcoming superstar.
Oh, yeah, he has superstar written all over him. And like I said earlier, trying to find out background, trying to find out history. Edge is not talking, and I can't find any resources. Can't find anybody who knows the story of Edge.
Edge giving away a considerable size and weight advantage here to Pierre. But there's the quickness of the 260-pounder Edge. And the boots down to the midsection.
I wonder if Pierre, the fellow Canadian, knows anything about Edge.
And here's Pierre now, whipping Edge into the ropes. Picks him up, spin Whoa. Around. Nice move by Edge. And Pierre now, a little breather outside the ring.
Well, I would gauge by that move that Edge has spent some time in Mexico, or at least studying some of the moves of the luchadors. Very impressive head scissor there.
Look out now. Here's Edge. Oh, my. The same move that injured Jose of Los Pericos a few weeks ago. And we got to take a look at this again. What finesse, what athleticism by Edge.
Certainly a dangerous maneuver, as you said. And Pierre almost went the same way as Jose, down across the shoulders and neck.
And here's Edge now, forearms to the face of Pierre, and now a rake of the eyes. Folks, don't forget, Fully Loaded in Your House, next Sunday live, exclusively on pay-per-view. I'll be in California, you'll be there too. I want a front row seat for the bikinis.
I mean, is it gonna be postage stamps and yarn thrown together for a bikini? I don't know.
Here's a cover by Edge and a kick out by Pierre.
But certainly, Sable's words are still ringing in my mind. What she wore at the Slammies last time, it's going to look like an evening gown compared to what she's planning for Fully Loaded.
Who do you give the Edge to?
Well, maybe Jacqueline's thinking twice after her venture on the top rope this past
week. That's right. And look at this. What a move by Pierre. You got to give the 300-pounder credit.
Just back off a knee injury. Pierre is not going to allow Edge to make a reputation on him, it appears.
And Edge now back to his feet. And Pierre going to work outside the ring. Talking about Fully Loaded. Announced this past week on Raw, Rock and Triple H title for title. But what about the new stipulation?
Oh, two out of three falls. And what a test of endurance. And there is going to be one man who will have to defeat the other two times to walk away with both championship belts.
I'll tell you what, The Rock and Triple H may not be any other superstars in the World Wrestling Federation in better shape cardiovascularly, and they're going to need it.
Well, they're not going to be able to wear each other down. Certainly, it becomes the situation with outside forces. Will they come into play? The feud between DX and The Nation heated up. Certainly, Jason Sensation felt the wrath of that. We're going to show you that tragic and that sickening, nearly criminal act by Owen Hart. We'll show you that at the completion of this matchup.
It's also DX versus The Nation when X-Pac takes on D'Lo at Fully Loaded.
Oh, yeah, brother D'Lo. You know he's looking for revenge as well, but that match is going to go 100 miles an hour.
Wow, what a power bomb.
Well, Pierre is exerting the weight advantage, exerting the experience advantage as well.
Fans don't like it. But Pierre, one half of the Quebecers. You know, Pierre's held the WWF Tag Team titles three separate occasions.
Yeah, you keep telling us that.
And there's a big boot now to the head. Tremendous athlete, though, for his size.
Well, he certainly is. A lot of people say, though, that if he was around that 260-pound range, he would be even better. But he uses his size to his advantage, especially in a matchup like this.
And he'll be tested this week on Raw, Brawl for All, against Dr. Death.
Oh, man. I mean, if I'm Pierre.
Here's a cover now and a kick out by Edge.
As soon as I'm done with this match, I'm going back to Quebec. I'm pulling the covers over my head, and I'm praying that Dr. Death doesn't come to my house.
Tell us about Dr. Death, Steve Williams.
Dr. Death, the four-time All-American. In fact, the last man collegiately to win the All-American honors in both football and wrestling.
In the same year.
In the same year. One of the greatest athletes ever. For the past few years, has competed in Japan. Is a legend all around the globe and is going to make his World Wrestling Federation debut this Monday.
Oh! A version of a flapjack there, I guess. Face first for Pierre. And Edge now in control. Scoop slam.
But Edge now to the second rope.
But Dr. Death is going to be donning the gloves in the brawl for all. He's going to look to make his reputation and the buzz around the locker room. Everybody that's involved in the brawl for all wants no part of Dr. Death.
Yeah, he seems to be the favorite to win the thing. We'll see. Have to see what happens.
And for you fans who have never seen this man in action, it is going to be a treat. Here comes that rolling dive again.
Missed it that time. Went to the well once too often. And Edge takes advantage.
The downward spiral.
Hooks the leg. It could be in, and it is. Edge victorious over Pierre.
Here is the winner, Edge.
Impressive. An up-and-coming superstar. The real deal.
There really seems to be some pain, some tragedy behind the eyes of Edge. I'm going to work to try to find out that story. Maybe I'll have something for you next week.
Hopefully we'll learn more in the weeks to come. As Edge heads back through the crowd.
Where does he go?
Good question. No one seems to know. Folks, plenty more still to come on Shotgun this